Greetings, fellow nerds. In a previous video, I asked for help in repairing my hot plate stirrers. I received a huge number of suggestions and offers, and I'd like to thank you for helping me out. First, an engineer generously fixed my old Ica hot plate. The particular problem was beyond my ability to fix, but I'm glad it was within theirs. If you're watching, thanks a lot. Now, my other two hot plates had burned out Mica heating elements. In my old videos, I asked for suggestions on how to replace them, if there were companies that could make them, or if anyone was willing to go in with me to group buy them. I received a huge number of suggestions, and I was given a company in China that could make the mica heating elements for much cheaper and in smaller quantities than the one I originally found. Instead of paying $3,000 for 100 units, I was quoted $500 for 30, and that was just within my ability to buy on my own. So I did, and here they are. Now I know I could have bought a whole new hot plate stirrer for that price, and I may indeed do so in the future. But I really want to fix my two existing ones, and having spare elements means I can be certain I'll always be able to fix them many times over. The certainty of being able to have two more working hot plates when I need them for years to come is slightly more valuable to me than having one new hot plate of uncertain lifetime and repairability. Especially since having two means one can be in service and one can be a backup. But I'm getting ahead of myself. Let's get these installed and tested. Interestingly enough, these holes match up perfectly with the elements they are replacing. Either the crude measuring picture I sent them of my burnt element was enough for perfect duplication, or this particular size and hole placement is pretty common and the company had the tooling and assembly line already on hand. Considering how willing they were to sell me just 30 units, which is well below the minimum order quantity of other companies, I think it's the latter. First, I'm going to repair the cheaper Cybasics brand hot plate. All I really gotta do is remove the old burned out heater element and replace it with a new element. The thermometer insulation has cracked and peeled off, so I'm insulating that with a mica sheet. You know, I'm actually somewhat impressed with the quality of the lead wires of the new elements. They took the time to insulate them and use quality connectors. They could have saved a few cents and not bother, but the fact they did raises my hope a bit that the nichrome foil element itself is better engineered than my previous elements. Only time will tell, but score one for this Chinese manufacturer. And there we go, this is heating up quite nicely. It works. Interestingly enough, you can see the hot plate smoking. Don't be alarmed, this is normal for a brand new element being turned on. The resins, machine oils, and adhesives used during manufacture are being burned off. After several minutes of a high heat, the plate will stop smoking and be ready for use. Obviously, do this part in fume hood. Anyway, I now have another hot plate stirrer back in service. Let me go to the next one. This ISG brand hot plate is actually a rebranded Dragon Labs or Cylogix hot plate. Let me take it apart. You know, while I'm here and have the hot plate top disassembled, I might as well clean and resurface this thing. It's been through hell and I won't get another opportunity like this for a while. First I'm going to grind off the residues with steel wool. To help it along, I'm going to use some oxalic acid and hydrochloric acid. Now I'm moving aside the hot plate unit and laying down some foil. Here's our chemically cleaned, ground, and washed hot plate top thoroughly dried. Now it just looks like it's been through war and not hell. To resurface this is pretty easy. We spray on this high temperature enamel paint. Usually you apply two separate coats, but I don't need my hot plate looking new. I just need it to look less like a meth lab auction sale. Most labs don't bother restoring the coating at all since it reduces thermal transfer ever so slightly. I wouldn't bother either, but this hot plate is essentially on display in my videos. I might as well make some effort to make it look good. Anyway, let me leave it overnight to dry. And here we are, a resurfaced hot plate top. Okay, let's get back to installing the new element. Now I'm not certain how long these elements will last in the long term, but you know what? Let's make an experiment out of that question. In 1 year, remind me to make another video commenting on the reliability of these elements over that year. Now I had a lot of suggestions for building a hot plate from scratch. I do intend to do that someday, but I needed working hot plates as soon as possible. I had many suggestions to build my own heater element using nichrome wire, and I tried, but I failed every time. The wires kept flexing and moving out of place and then shorting out. I didn't have the mechanical skill to do it. I'm not saying it can't be done or even that's hard. I'm just that bad that I couldn't make a wire element myself and had to get these elements manufactured. If you can build your own wire elements, then by all means do that. Anyway, a fully refurbished hot plate. Let me test it out. And it's working too. Looks like I'm back in business. Time to start on some real chemistry again. Thanks again, my viewers, for helping me out. One of you outright fixed my hot plate, and some others found a manufacturer for the heating elements of these other hot plates. I went from zero to three functioning hot plates, and I couldn't have done it without your help. Thanks. Special thank you to all of my supporters on Patreon for making these science videos possible with their donations and their direction. If you're not currently a patron but would like to support the continued production of science videos like this one, then check out my Patreon page here or in the video description. I really appreciate any and all support.